is, of course, The Plug. Right about now, we get right on to the feature, which is simply called Empowering Your Vision, right here on number two, station of choice. And I don't do it alone, man. The man behind the feature is called Mr. Makwana. Mr. Makwana, how are you doing?
Hi, Zandile. How are you doing?
I am amazing.
I'm great as well. I had a very great time at Eswatini. I cannot complain at all.
We can see that you had a splendid time. Go Eswatini. Oh yeah, it's called Eswatini now. No more Swaziland. Like basic hele.
Yes.
Yeah, but anyway, Sean obviously is here. Hi, Sean.
Good morning, Tato.
Wow, the voice. Okay. Are you good?
I'm good.
Okay. All right. Okay. Let's just do this, Mr. Makwana. Let's just get on to the topic of discussion today. Please, of course, do greet the listeners.
All right, we'd like to greet the listeners, and we'd like to thank God for this opportunity now, for those who are listening right now, that you may take something away and it could impact and change your life somehow. Today's topic, we continue with the topic we left with a week before last. We talked about the relationship with yourself, and we realized that everything else in our lives gets better or gets worse because of the relationship we have with ourselves, that we cannot have any empowering and beautiful and fruitful relationship with other people unless we have the relationship with ourselves.
Say the last part again.
We cannot have any beautiful, empowering and amazing relationship with other people if we don't have that with ourselves first.
Yes.
You need to learn to love yourself so that you can properly understand
how to love the next person.
Yeah, and your expectation of what love is.
Exactly.
Okay.
It's like a practicing ground on yourself. Yeah. The things you do for yourself, it's impossible to go and do an extra mile in someone else before you can do that for yourself, because you know what true demonstration of love is.
No, I get it now. I just needed clarification on it. Let's get to the quote of the day. Thought of the day. What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us. Let me say this again.
Yes.
What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us. I literally need one to explain this for me. As I was reading it, I was trying to try and understand it.
Yes.
But please, I need help.
All right. What lies before us, that is in front of us, and what lies behind us are tiny matters compared to what lies within ourselves. That sometimes when we look in front of us, the journey we have to go that is going to evolve on our personal journey, we think that there's so much that we cannot deal with. And when we look back at the things that we have gone through, the things that we are able to make a breakthrough through, the beautiful things and the bad things, the letdowns and the good memories, we think, oh no man, now I don't have that ability anymore. But the truth of the matter is that all those things that you have experienced and the things you are going to experience, they are tiny matters compared to what lies within you. You have that great potential in you to still express and to navigate through life. That sometimes we must realize that we only let ourselves down. There are so many things that have happened for us, and there are so many things that seems like they are going to happen in our lives. And because we don't think that we have that power and energy and that motivation, the courage to keep on going and getting better every single day, we want to give up. But giving up is not an option when we are aware right now that we have so much power inside of us that we were given to be able to withstand whatever that we are facing.
One would want to know, but where do we actually derive, where do we actually get that, you know, that motivation, that power, and that keeps us going? Like, how do you even get there? How do you even attain such, you know, confidence in yourself? Yeah. Like, these are things that I would personally want to understand and know.
And you know what the beautiful thing about the statement is? It says that what lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters. This means that the experiences that you have gone through that have created the person that you are before are really very small compared to the person that you can become. Even the things that you think that are still yet to come, that you are yet to experience, compared to what you can unleash to borrow Mr. Makwana's first book's title, Unleash Your Potential.
Yes.
His first seminar, Unleash Your Potential.
Yeah.
You get to get inside of yourself and unearth that talent. Now, when you speak of how to become that person, this is the journey that we call personal development.
Yeah.
The tiny little steps that we've been taking since the beginning of the year, this is what you are building up to.
Mm.
You are tapping into that within yourself. You understand? You've been watering a plant. You are basically a seed. Think of yourself as that seed with the ability to become the majestic oak tree or the even more majestic baobab tree in African terms, just to be a bit more relatable. You water yourselves through these daily inspirations, through learning, through putting yourselves out of your comfort zone, through internetworking with like-minded individuals, through seeking growth and taking an intentional mindset when it comes to the things that excite you, that interest you, that you are passionate about, that bring you ultimate joy and happiness. And that's how you then gain confidence to take the next step, by realizing that there was this little bridge a year ago, you had no blog. You had aspirations and intentions and thoughts of becoming a blogger. But now, a year later, in a short space of 12 months, you are a blogger with followers. And every video that you post gets reactions, gets comments. And this is the realization. And with every video, from your first to your current one, and more that will come, you realize that there has been a steady growth. So that is the confidence that you seek by becoming, by doing.
Mm.
That is then when you have tapped into that power within.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's the incomparable.
And I like that you say, when you look back, because most of the time we think we are not able to take another step forward because we are not aware of the progress we have made.
Yes.
So when you give that yourself time to look back and say, but you know, this is not where I was a week ago.
Yeah.
It sets us and liberates us into that power and potential.
Uh-huh. Let's get to the first point. Control the controllables. Control the controllables. Be at peace with what is beyond your ability. Be at peace with what is beyond your ability.
Oh. You know this one, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
We say this one a lot.
Yeah.
A lot. Mm-hmm. It is our driving force. It is our brain. Yeah. It is. It's very interesting that you would put it here as the very, very first point, because a lot of times Thato and myself talk about, maybe more especially when we are maybe at loggerheads with certain things that are outside of our control, and we always say, you know, you do that which you focus on. That which is within your power to change, and allow those other things to exist. But you are aware of them. But because you cannot control them, you control that which you are, which is yourself.
Powerful. Mm-hmm. Actually, this is the first chapter of my second book, Embrace Your Greatness, where I talk that for so many times we are trying to control the things we cannot control.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I work with organizations, with employees from different organizations. And part of it is that you find that we have employees, those who are not willing to execute for what they sign that they are going to execute in. And you cannot do anything about it. And sometimes we are busy trying to get them on board that we suffocate the time we should give for people who are already on board, who can do the work. And we have this one employee now who we are giving all the time, trying to give all the resources. And no matter what you do, until they are able to say, you know what, I am sick and tired of doing this thing. I'm sick and tired of people saying, hey, please always show up. Now we are getting in a position where we are giving people who deserve our time the time, and things get on the way of progress. So many people today, Sean and Zandile, people are letting themselves down because they are trying to control that which is beyond their ability. And therefore, they don't have time for what they are able to work on. Most of the time, life passes by when we are busy trying to fix the things that we cannot control. And we know for sure the only person and the only thing that we have control over is ourselves. The moment we do what we call self-regulation and get in a path and say, God, give me the strength, you know, to change that which I can change, and, you know, that wisdom to know which I cannot, and the wisdom to know the difference. Up until we get in that position, we are not able to make real progress. We walk around with broken hearts, with, you know, pain, because we are still thinking of the things that are beyond our control. It is okay to get in a position where you are not able to figure things out. It's okay to get in a position where you don't know the answer and you are willing to say, even though I don't know the answer, I am going to do my part, and as time goes, I will see what happens. And we know what has happened in our past, where we wanted to take something on and things were not going as planned. But as we kept on going, things doors kept on opening, and that is the test of life. Life is always testing and seeing you, how serious you really want the things you say you want, because sometimes the dots, you don't know the clues, but as you take steps, that faith, and life requires you to take that faith.
Mm-hmm. I remember one of the greatest Chinese emperors that ever lived, Mao Zedong, who was the father of the Han Dynasty, I think, or came just before the Han Dynasty. And he was born out of a poor family, but there's a very inspiring quote that he came up with that says, so many deeds cry out to be done, but always urgent. The world rolls on and time presses. Yeah. 10,000 years are too long.
Yeah.
Seize the day, seize the hour.
Yeah.
So that's a very, very powerful concept when you talk about being able to take, when you talk about the concept of time, mm-hmm. and spending your resources on things that are not yielding or bearing you fruit. You have to be focused. You have to seize the day. You have to seize the moment. Because if you continue to try and seek or try and water a seed, some seeds have been infected.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Some seeds are rotten.
Yeah.
Right from the onset.
Yeah, even from the Bible.
Yeah.
You know.
Some seeds will fall on ground, on ground.
Yeah.
That will nurture them. Some seeds will grow there. Mm. Will land there. So be perceptive of the kind of nurturing that you are providing, and where you are providing, and where you are putting and wasting your resources, basically. And realize that you want to attain a certain level of growth.
Okay, let me just continue. I wanted to say something, but of course, time. let me just continue, okay? The second one says, value yourself. Don't attach your worth to things and others. Value yourself. Don't attach your worth to things and others.
What do you think it means that the value that we should attach to ourselves without attaching it to others and things?
To me, it goes to, there's a song by Teenage. It says, I know who I am.
Yeah.
And the message behind the song, I mean, it's just, I know who I am. You need to understand who you are. You need to know your worth. You need to know, okay, what you stand for. And after you knowing what you stand for, you will then, you won't even need any validation from Sean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If at all you understand what you are doing, if at all you understand where you are in life, if you are still at step one, you are there for a reason.
Yeah.
You need to go through step one in order for you to get to step two.
Yeah.
You cannot jump from step one to step five.
Exactly.
Without acquiring the levels from step 2, 3, and 4. There's a reason why those steps are there in life.
That
for you to learn, that for you to understand, okay, when I get to step 5, what it goes back to the first point, you know?
Yeah.
It goes back to what you said about actually the quote of the day.
Yeah.
You know, it goes back to, okay, from the back, like
from the past.
You know, you need, sometimes the reason why we are living, we need to experience, you know, life itself, the good and the bad.
Yeah.
So to me,
let's value yourself.
Value yourself more.
Yeah. Exactly.
Understand yourself, you know, feel free with yourself, embrace yourself.
Do you know what I get? I hear this. I don't know if I should say, maybe throughout my past and as I was growing up and learning it and hearing it, people saying it.
Mm.
It's a beautiful concept. It's a great idea. But the even when you type it and say, and you post maybe a picture of your significant other and the caption is, he completes me.
Mm.
Yes.
Or she completes. It's a beautiful idea. It's a great sentiment. My other half. But in essence, what are you saying about self?
Very true, that's powerful, man.
I am incomplete.
I need someone else to complete.
I am not full, I am not worthy.
I'm going to object.
I'm saying it is a beautiful idea.
It's a great concept. It's a marvelous idea.
Let's hear what
but
he
think
has
about
to say.
What you are speaking
about
of self.
Yeah.
No, I get you.
You understand?
Yeah.
You need some sort of validation, some sort of acceptance. This is because you don't speak your language of love about yourself to very yourself true, so. Fully.
Yeah, that's very powerful. And yeah, you can say a thing.
Yeah.
Okay. To me, I take it, when I see such posts, yeah. when I do such posts, I take it as an appreciation.
Yes. Oh, okay.
Yes.
A beautiful idea.
It's a beautiful idea.
It's a beautiful idea.
Yeah.
We're not saying, if they're not there, I am nothing. But, I am 50%.
Yeah.
I'm saying, those people are there for a reason in my life.
Yeah.
You get it?
Yeah.
We always talk about how we need people to move on. You know, you need to learn from people. You can't just be yourself. Hello, boo. In life.
But I always say, words are very powerful things.
Yeah.
They are. That's why it's called spelling. You understand?
Mm.
You cast a spell of sorts with your words.
Mm.
So you are speaking this incompleteness into existence in your life. As much as the beauty and appreciation of. So if you are appreciative, then craft the message in saying,
I value
this human being, and highlight those aspects that you value, that you love about them. Bring those to the forefront. But if you say those things about this person complete you, even if you are not, you are creating that within the realm of your reality. You are speaking it into existence.
Yeah.
And you will therefore begin to now love in a way that creates that condition.
That dependence. Yes. Oh, man, that's very powerful. And that is why we are seeing every now and then relationship break up, marriage break up, end up in depression, people killing themselves because now the worth they were expecting from someone else is taken away when someone leaves. When you say, hey, you are our really, really employee. Yes, we want to celebrate you, but we would want to create a space where now you start stepping on our heads because now we are saying you do your work well. You are always replaceable.
Yeah.
And now that thing on its own, we cannot change anything in the outside, our first point. We can regulate ourselves and we can only get better to put ourselves in a space where we are not replaceable by increasing the value we have as an individual.
Mm.
Being able to sit down and say, I am worth it. I have this full, you know, love, this full caring, that when someone else shows up, they show up with the other value they want to put in your life. So I think this element of value yourself, do not depend on other things. And other things may be work titles. We have people right now who have destroyed relationship because of the titles they hold in their workplaces. People who have destroyed their marriages because of the way they view themselves. When you view yourself as inadequate, now you get in there. You think it's about you. So it's always about now reflecting in what you think about yourself. The reality you have in your head. You know, some people can fight you not because you are wrong, but because of this reality they have in their heads of the perfect person, of the perfect workplace, of the perfect that. And at the end of the day, the value they are you are talking about. So even when we share something, which has nothing, but now let's understand as 2020 evolves that we have to attach value to ourselves, not to our networks, not to our job, not to our relationship, but knowing, you know, from a day one that we do have that self-worth, that we deserve to be here. You are part of these stars. You are part of this universe. And without you, the universe is short of something. So you have a value and something to contribute. Now, every single day when we wake up, let us be willing to let our light to shine.
Let's go to this one. Express yourself. Express your beliefs, value, and principles.
Sean? Yeah, it's a very important one. You know, you have to let your light shine. Just picking up on Mr. Makwana's last point there. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Yeah.
We have, just to borrow from Nelson Mandela's inaugural speech at the Union Buildings in Pretoria in 94, when he was inaugurated as South Africa's first black president. You know, he quote, there was a line in his speech that says, "It is our light not our darkness that most frightens us. And when you allow your light to shine, you inadvertently give those around you permission to do the same. It is because of the humanness of our condition that we are creatures of a herd or crowd mentality.
Yeah.
So when you see one of our own rise up above the challenges that we continue to perceive in our world, you tend to also believe in yourself and your ability to shine and rise above your own circumstances. So the beauty of expressing yourself is not only just for yourself, but for the beauty, for the power of sparking a revolution of greatness amongst your peers. When Mr. Makwana began this journey as a trainer and coach and motivator, it sparked a revolution within his immediate circle, within the people that knew him. Even at an extended point, there were people that were from his past that became better versions of themselves because he followed his values and his principles and committed intentionally, intentional thought behind it to those steps, and that in itself created this program that we have, this path that we're on. So by unleashing your poetry, by expressing yourself. You ultimately hand over the torch. So burn bright.
And I also, it creates a sense of worth in yourself.
Yeah.
To know that even though there are so many things in the outside, your position and your values, they still matter. That things around you, they may have carry so much value that we think we don't fit in. But the day we start expressing who we are, we start realizing and seeing beautiful things coming out because of our uniqueness. That when we allow other people to see what we are capable of doing, the skills and the abilities and the joy that we have in our lives, we allow other people to steal, like Sean say, to do the same. There are things that I would never have thought to do unless I saw Zandile Adira something there, unless I saw Sean Adira something there. And that small expressions of who they are, it gives and ignites that expressions in myself, that we are doing what we are seeing. And as we do that, we build an energy of people who are creative, of people who are productive, people who are excellent. It's other people seeing what they are capable of doing that sparks in that in us.
Express yourself. Let's just move on to the last one. Don't define your outcomes as your identity. Don't define your outcomes as your identity. To me, this goes to failures in life. How you're not supposed to... I mean, there are two things. It's either you win or you lose.
Yeah.
That is just how it is. We get into this life thing without even knowing what we're going to do, how the results may turn out.
Yeah.
It can either be positive or negative. But either way, you learn something out of it.
Yeah.
That's just where I stop.
I think that's a good observation, that there's no manual, like Sean will say, life.
Little important facts excluded.
So we are always figuring things out as we take steps of faith towards what we want to get. But also with success, there are people whose little success has killed their potential because they thought, oh man, I'm the man.
Yeah.
And that I am the man, I have arrived mentality has derailed everything. We know people who are doing up well, upcoming artists, upcoming fashion, upcoming vlogger, or young celebrated leader in Botswana. And all of a sudden, that thing on its own now, they were like, oh, I am that. Sometimes you are not yet your full potential. But because some people are so scared of stepping in that journey of expressing themselves, they think that is greatness, while it is not. People normally say, oh man, you have already arrived. I tell them it's even 1% of what's in my head, right? And if I allow other people to say, you are the man, I am not the man. I end up derailing on my way. So you are a powerful being. And being here means you still haven't expressed part of you.
When I read Don't Define Your Outcomes as Your Identity, I remembered a couple of, I think about 8-9 odd years ago when I started this job here. I remember 3 to 6 a.m. was the first show that I had, and it was mind blowing. It was very beautiful thing to finally make it to national radio. And I remember praying on my first show. Just before I started, I was like, please, dear God, don't allow this to go to my head.
Yeah.
I really hope and pray that I stay the same.
Wow.
And that is when the whole concept behind he's not small Sean, he's not big Sean,
oh, wow,
he
man.
Is just Sean came into being. That's the original background to that thought.
Wow.
And I've always tried to remain true to yourself, because if I lose focus, I will forget what the ultimate end goal is. This is just part of a very exciting and beautiful journey.
Exactly.
And as beautiful and nurturing and growing as it has been, if I had been comfortable and maybe gotten too excited, maybe my radio days would have ended up at 3 to 6. But we graduated to the breakfast show, which starts in about 5 minutes from this point. So, 15, just after the news.
Yeah.
And that's a little bit of growth and a bit of paying attention and staying focused and not losing sight of oneself. And every other thing that I've done on the side has been building up to the ultimate end goal.
I'm learning from you.
Very powerful.
And it's a very long journey.
And I love that, Sean, that our growth is dependent on how far we can be able to hold ourselves accountable to be who we are. That people say, I feel lost, I don't know what to do, because they've lost their identity along the way.
Yeah.
There's a chapter in my book, the first book, Find Yourself Anyway, that things get nasty. We get lost in this jungle of life when we forget who we are.
Yes.
We are our inner self compass. That when we know who we are and what we stand for, we ultimately arrive where we are supposed to be. Why? Because our heart and our intuition already knows why we were created.
Yes.
There's no answers in the outside. The answers is inside of you. When you find that things are overwhelming at workplace and everywhere, find yourself. You are the one who is going to get you to the maker at the end of the day.
Even in religion, even in the good books and scriptures, the kingdom of God is within you.
Amen. That's powerful. Amen.
Do not seek it anywhere else.
Just here.
Inside of you.
Within.
I like taking the example of when God created the first man. He molded the dust, cosmic particles, and created the structures that would then become Adam. He who from all others came.
Mm,
yeah,
yes.
That's what the Hebraic meaning of Adam is, and he breathed the breath of life into this creation of his, and that's what animated it. So that he put a little part of himself inside of himself, inside of this first man. And when you look at that concept, that no two breaths are the same, our individuality and uniqueness is that you are a different breath of God. You are a different breath of God, and I am also a different breath of the great divine. So go out there and express that version of yourself, and shine and be the best version of yourself that you can be. I think that's basically the take home that we should be leaving with from this, when you form the relationship of learning to love yourself.
I was sure you're going to say from this sermon.
from this sermon, spiritual.
Amen.
Wow, all right. My number is 7477619674776196.
All right, Sean.
Yes, follow us on Facebook. We are a Captain Sean. And of course, like that page, drop us a like. There's a couple of new images that we'll be making around this week.
Very, very, very fire.
Yeah.
That's great. I like the haircuts.
Thank you so much. As we continue to accept and learn to love ourselves even more.
All right, it's 5:57 and up to your station of choice, man. I don't know why you guys are making me laugh. But anyway, we meet again tomorrow, same time, same place, 10th of March, 2020. If it was your birthday, happy birthday to you. Otherwise, my name is Thato Zandile. But we're coming up next. It is, of course, the News Bulletin, leaving you with music of Katy Perry, Unconditional. Goodbye.
watching me. Don't need apologies. Know that you are.